In this video, we will demonstrate 5 common DSM login issues. If you come across any of the issues, you can find the timestamp of each solution in the video description. But first, please check whether you have administrative privileges to the NAS or whether you are one of the administrators. If you're not an administrator, please contact the administrators for assistance. If you've forgotten your DSM username and password, please ask an administrator to sign in to the DSM. Launch Control Panel. Click User. Select the account you want to make changes to and click Edit. Now you can change the password. Click OK to save the changes. Reset the administrator's login password if no administrators can help you reset your DSM password. Please refer to the video description for the video on resetting passwords. If you see a message saying that your IP address has been blocked because of too many failed login attempts, it means that you can no longer sign in to your DSM using that IP address. A simple way to solve this is to change the IP address of your device. You can do so by connecting your device to a different network, such as switching from Wi-Fi to 4G, or simply sign in to your DSM using another device. Now that you've signed in to your DSM, let's remove the blocked IP address. Launch Control Panel and change the display mode on the upper right corner to Advanced Mode. Click Security. Click Account. Click Allow Block List. And click Block List. Select the IP address that's been blocked. Click Remove. And click Delete again to remove the blocked IP address. If you need to disable two-step verification after you lost or changed your mobile phone, ask an administrator to sign in to the DSM. Then launch Control Panel. Click User. Double-click on the user account where two-step verification needs to be disabled and click Reset Two-Step Verification at the bottom left corner of the info page. Reset the administrator account. If no administrators can help you reset the verification code, please refer to the video description for the video on resetting passwords. If you see a message saying that the disk space is full, it's likely that the system partition is full, not the storage pool or volume that stores data. Restart the system if this message appears. To do so, long press the power button on your NAS till you hear a beep. Wait till the LED stops blinking, and then long press the power button again to restart your NAS. If the message is still shown, please contact Synology Technical Support for assistance. If you see a message saying that you're not authorized to use this service, it means that the DSM account for accessing this NAS has been denied. If this happens, ask an administrator to sign in to the DSM and then launch Control Panel. Click Privileges. Select DSM. Click Edit. Find your account and tick Allow. Then click OK. If the solutions mentioned in this video cannot solve your DSM login issues, please go to help.synology.com for more information. To get the most out of your Synology NAS, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel or click another video to keep watching.